Dallas. Thank you for being here. Thank you, thank you. Everybody get a good picture. This might be the last time they see my ass in public. Got some kind of disguise. How are you? Every once in a while, a guy walks out onto the stage and realizes that he wore the wrong shirt. Tired as fuck out here. Please, everybody, relax. Get comfortable. Have a seat. Thank you very much. My first day. It's my first day as a 40-year-old. As many blacks and Mexicans know, it is very hard to become 40. I have beat insurmountable odds. Shit's like the opposite of Precious. I couldn't even watch Precious. I've never seen a movie where every bad thing ever had happened to somebody for 90 minutes. It had to be the saddest fucking movie I ever saw in my life. That's what I learned. I think that's why I'm back out, because I realized life is hard. You think things are going good, the next thing you know, someone you called a nigger 30 years ago tells on you. Hired the Food Network. Man, 30 years is a long time. A lot of white people didn't know there's no statute of limitations for calling people niggers. Everyone started thinking back, well, I guess once in traffic, maybe I pretty fucking hard to get fired from the Food Network. I should feel bad. Unfortunately, I'm used to it. I think every couple years, some white celebrity just freaks out and calls everybody niggers. Harriet Kramer did it because it was still a new phenomenon. I was mad as shit because I'm a Seinfeld fan. I was like, oh, Kramer, that's fucked up. I like it. That was the black dude in me. The comedian in me was just like, oof. This nigga's having a tough show. Man, that Kramer. Don't let it break it. Man, I'm Kramer. Deep down, it's fucked up, but I kind of wish I was there. It's a dark thought, but it's true. It's kind of like, you know what I mean? Having tickets to see Siegfried and Roy, the ninth tiger bit that motherfucker's throat at his head. It's dark, but that's why you go to the tiger show. You don't go thinking you're gonna see somebody be safe with tigers. You go thinking in the back of your mind, this motherfucker might get bit. It'd be an amazing thing to see for $35. And some people are actually there. Someone has a t-shirt like, I was there the night Kramer called everybody. You know, but I can relate, because he was having a bad show, and shit, I had a bad show the other night. It happens in show business. We all have bad shows sometimes, but I've never had a show so bad that I had to meet with Jesse Jackson, like, immediately after. That's a fucking terrible show. You guys are like, fuck that cell phone announcement, I'm just going to film you anyway. Looks like I have a comedy special coming out on YouTube sometime later tonight. Can't say that's not fucking annoying. What am I, Drake?
Starting from the bottom, Nelly. Yeah.
I know you love me, sir, because it's hot and your seats are probably.
Probably what?
This arena is beautiful, but it's fucking like sweltering hot. I feel like Johnny Cash in a prison show. This road and sweaty crowd kind of stinks a little bit. It's crazy. Not your attitude, your actual body smell funny. We're just too close to one another, like a white church. That was a bad analogy. I've never even been to one. I have been to white church, isn't it? But all kinds of churches. Yeah. Christmas. So I called Paul D. Xavier. See if I can get her to be my personal chef. I don't know about the food network, but my friends would love that shit.
I'd be interested in where she's gonna get out of fry these niggas some chicken. Make you like one of those homemade bread. Apple pie with whipped cream. Dirty in there as well. And it's please, because I'm the first racist kid to have
you. I don't give a fuck. Who fries my chicken? If I went to KFC and looked in the kitchen and everyone had clams lips on, I'd be like, this is dumb, burning. Work all that other shit out later, but this chicken better have every land 16 herbs and spices. No real chicken, it should all be here.
It's exhausting! It's just exhausting.
Crazy racism. You know, at least I saw a movie about racism. It's called Lincoln. Very good movie. First movie I've ever seen about slavery with no black people in it. Very refreshing. Just white people talking about black people and black people like listening.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Lincoln. He's a good man. But, did you get the sandwich bigger? I didn't.
I'm getting lucky that station like that. You were actually good. I would have liked to have been in Lincoln. There was just no part for me. Maybe I could have played like Frederick Douglass and then walk on or something.
I thought Frederick Douglass was going to do a cameo of Mr. Lincoln. Frederick Douglass here to see what's happening.
See what's happening.
Sign that bill. Harry, take this here. She has some secret diamonds for you.
It was brilliant in some places, but god damn, it's a hard one to watch. Leonardo DiCaprio was too good of an actor. I gotta choke his ass out on the set. I already know him. They had to get me a stuntman. And they were like, Captain, some other black dude walked in, nigga, Captain, and I come back.
Can you know what you mean?
At least it was overtly racist. I didn't mind that as much as those quietly racist movies. You know what I mean? Where you think they might be talking about, like Planet of the Apes. Boy, that's what I'm saying. I'm talking about the original. Did that movie make you feel uncomfortable? Come on, man. The ape's name was Cornelius. I was like, word?
Cornelius.
I have an uncle named Cornelius. It's a very, very uncomfortable name. They had a blowout perm like Superfly. I'm like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Why does this fake perm?
Where's Neil?
I wouldn't even know where to start. The president's been black, damn it, the whole time after I put my shirt. If I know that's going to happen, I'm going to never put it.